Good morning, student. Today we are going to discuss chapter 8, comparing quantity, exercise 8.2, question number 6. Question number 6 have, during a sale, a shop offered a discount of 10% on the marked price of all items. What would our customer have to pay for a pair of jeans marked at 1450 rupees and two shirts marked at 850 rupees each? So here customer buy a pair of jeans, marked price of a pair of jeans is 1450 rupees and two shirts. The marked price of each shirt is 850 rupees, and discount offered by the shop is 10% off on the marked price of all the items. Okay, so first we find the total marked price of pair of jeans and two shirts. Okay, so first we write marked price. Marked price of pair of jeans. Okay, so here marked price we write MP. MP of pair of jeans. Okay, we write MP. This is a marked price. Okay, so first marked price of pair of jeans is 1450 rupees. Okay, pair of jeans is equal to 1450 rupees. This is clear. The marked price of pair of jeans is 1450 rupees. Also given the marked price of shirts. One shirt is 850, so we find the marked price of two shirt. Okay, so MP of two shirts, this is equal to what? 2 into one shirt has 850 rupees, so this is equal to rupees 17, 1700 rupees. Okay, so marks of two shirt is 1700. It means 2 into 850, because this is given the mark price of one shirt is 850 rupees. So mark price of two shirt is 2 into 850 rupees. This is equal to 1700. This is clear. Now we find total marks, total MP of jeans and total MP, marked price of jeans, pair of jeans and two shirt. Okay, so that here total total MP. MP means marks price of a pair of jeans and two shirt. This is equal to what? You can write it. The pair of jeans is 1450 rupees plus the pair of jeans is 1450 rupees. This is given, and also this is given, and the mark price of two shirt is finally 1700 rupees. Clear? This is equal to rupees 1700. So you can find it. You can sum 0 plus 0, this is equal to 0 again, 0 plus 5 again, it's 5, this 5. Now this is 100, this is 7 plus 4 is equal to what? 7 plus 4 is equal to 11. Okay, carry 1, 1 plus 1, this is equal to 2, and carry 1, this is equal to 3. So in this way you can see the total marks price of a pair of jeans and two shirt. This is equal to what? This is equal to 3150 rupees. Now, so shop offered a discount of 10% on mark price of all items. Okay. So what is discount? Discount is given. Discount percentage. Discount percentage is given here 10%. Okay, discount percentage is given here 10%. So question asks, we find discount on which? BMP, mark price, RSP, selling price, RCP, cost price. So in every well, we find discount only mark price. Okay, so shop offer 10% discount on each items of mark price. So here our total mark price is 3,250 rupees. So we find discount. So discount is equal to, this is discount percentage, 10%. So discount is equal to MP into 10/100. Okay. So here MP we find 3,150. Total, this is our total MP. Okay. And discount 10% 10/100. So you can see 10 can see here 10 can see. So you find discount rupees 350. Clear? We find a discount rupees 350. So what is the selling price of the one jeans, a pair of jeans and two shirt? Okay. So selling price is, if you subtract discount from the mark price, then you obtain selling price of shirt and pair of jeans. Okay. So you can write here selling price of also you can say the customer pay money. Okay. We can selling price of a pair of jeans and two shirt is equal to MP minus discount. Okay. Or you can say customer pay money. Okay. Customer have to pay. Okay. MP minus discount, or you can say selling price of a pair of jeans and two shirt. This is equal to what? This is equal to nothing but you can say MP mark price minus discount. Okay, minus discount. So MP here given, total MP is 3150 rupees minus 350. This is discount rupees 350. This is here given discount. Clear? So you subtract it, 350 rupees minus 3150 rupees minus 315. If you subtract with separate here 5, this is 4 minus 1, 3, this is here 3, take carry 1, this is 8, 2, 2,835 rupees. Okay. So customer have to pay rupees 2,835 rupees. Clear? 2,835 rupees have to pay customers. Okay. So we can write here. We can write in this question. This is given that during a sale, a shop offered a discount of 10% on the marked price of all items. What would a customer have to pay for a pair of jeans marked at 1450 rupees and two shirt marked at rupees 850 each? Okay, so in this case we can solve this question two types. First type is that if you find discount of jeans, then up you find selling price of jeans. Again you find the discount of marked price of two shirts. After this you find discount of two shirts. After this you find selling price of two shirts. Then next you sum the selling price of pair of jeans and the selling price of two shirts. Then this amount have to pay by customer. Okay, so and the second types of is that first we find the mark price of two shirt 1700 and mark price of a pair of jeans is given 1450 rupees. This is given. So first we find the total mark price of a pair of jeans and two shirt. So this is called to be summing 1450 rupees. This is the mark price of pair of jeans and 1700 rupees. This is the mark price of two shirt. Okay. When you sum them, then we obtain 3150 rupees. This is the mark price of a pair of jeans and two shirt. Which is the total mark price of pair of. This is total mark price of pair of jeans and two shirt. This is called to 3150. And in this question also given discount percentage 10%. Okay, so you find here discount. What is discount? You find discount at MP, mark price. So your mark price is given 3150 into 10/100. So you can see you find the mark price of total. Discount of total mark price is 350 rupees. Okay, so here you need to find selling price of pair of jeans and two shirts is mark price minus discount. So here our total mark price is 3150 rupees minus 314. This is a 15. This is mark price. When you subtract it, then you obtain 2835 rupees. So student, you can see we solve these questions and I hope all of you understood. At last you can write, and therefore customer have to pay 2835 rupees. Okay, at last you can write here. Therefore, customer have to pay rupees 2835. Okay, this is clear. And you can also use first method. First you find discount at selling price of jeans, a pair of jeans. So selling price of pair of jeans, you can find it by subtract discount minus MP minus discount. So let's see. We solve in second way. So first you find selling price, discount on a pair of jeans. Here first let here discount is equal to 10%. Okay, so selling price of a pair of jeans, right here. Selling price, selling price of pair of
there are leaves. This is come to marked price. Marked price minus discount. Okay. So here we write marked price is 1450 rupees. Clear? And minus discount, you know, available. You will find discount at MP marked price. So rupees 1450 into 10% of marked price. So 10 pencil or 10 pencil, and we have here rupees 1450 minus rupees 1145. Clear? So here you can see, if you subtract them, 1450 minus 145. This is equal to what? Here 5, here 4, 0, here 3, 2, 1. So you can see the selling price of a pair of jeans is what? Rupees 1205. Clear? If you subtract this, then you have 10. Here 10, I, this is equal to 4, 4 minus 4 is 0. Here this is equal to 4. 4 minus 1, this is equal to 3. Sorry, this is equal to 3. Nothing, this is equal to 3. So here you can write 3. In this way, you can see the pair, the selling price of a pair of jeans. This is equal to nothing but 1305 rupees. Now you find the selling price of 2 shirts. Okay, because the cost price of 1 shirt is given 850 rupees. So cost, ठीक है, so mark price of given of this shirt is 850 rupees. So MP of 2 shirt is 1700 rupees. Okay, now you write here selling. Okay, selling price. Selling price, you can say selling price is SP of 2 shirt. SP of 2 shirt is equal to mark price AMP minus discount. Clear? Mark price of the 2 shirt minus discount. MP minus D. D represent discount and MP represent mark price of each shirt. Okay? So here this, you find the mark price of 2 shirt is 1700 minus discount. Discount is equal to 1700 into 10/100. This is equal to 0 pence. We have 170 rupees have discount at 2 shirt. So you can write here rupees 1700 minus rupees 170, this is discount. So 1700 minus rupees what? 170. This is 0, this is 110, 3, here 6, we have 5. Okay, so the subtract 170 is the discount, 170 is the discount, and mark price of the 2 shirt is 1700, but you find discount 170. If you subtract 170 from the mark price, then you obtain selling price of 2 shirt. So you subtract here 0 minus 0, 0 minus 7, this is equal to 3, now this is 6 minus 1, so to 5 and 5. So here you can see the selling price of 2 shirt is equal to 1530 rupees. This is the selling price of 2 shirt. Okay, so we need to find customer have to pay. How many amount the customer have to pay? Customer have to pay two amounts. This is the selling price of जींस 1305 प्लस 1530 रुपीज़, ओके। सो यू नीड टू फाइंड कस्टमर हैव टू पे, सो फॉर दिस यू कैन राइट हियर कस्टमर हैव टू पे, यू नीड टू फाइंड कस्टमर है टू पे, व्हाट अमाउंट हैव टू कस्टमर पे, सो कस्टमर हैव टू पे 1305 रुपीज फॉर जींस एंड रुपीज 1530 फॉर टू शर्ट, सो टोटल अमाउंट ऑफ मनी पे बाई कस्टमर ई बीस इज इक्वल टू ₹2835।
ओके, दिस इज क्लियर स्टूडेंट, आई होप ऑल ऑफ अंडरस्टूड, आई ऑल ऑफ अंडरस्टूड बोथ वे डेट यू कैन सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन। ओके, सो नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, व्हाट इज द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, लेट्स सी। नाउ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 7। In question number 7, this is given and that a milk man sold two of his buffaloes for 20,000 rupees each. On one he made a gain of 5% and another loss of 10%. Find the overall gain or loss. Okay, so here milkman sold two buffaloes in 20,000, so it means this is given, the SP of one fellow is 20,000 rupees, so SP of two fellow is 2 into 20,000 rupees, so in this way you can find here SP of two fellows is 14,000 rupees, so here you need to find the overall gain or loss in whole transactions. Okay, overall gain or loss in whole transactions, this is clear. Now so for this we find the cost, we find the CP of each buffalo because he sold two different rate of his buffalo. First he sold 5% profit and the second he sold 10% loss. Okay, so we need to find their selling cost price of the each buffalo. So let's see, first write here selling price of each buffalo. Okay, selling price of each buffalo load is equal to rupees 20,000. Okay, so milkman sold two buffalo, so you write a selling price of two buffalo. Okay, so selling price of two buffalo, this is called 2 into rupees 20,000. Okay, so it's become rupees 40,000. Okay, so we have selling price of 2 buffalo is total, means total SP is 40,000 rupees, and we need to find the total CP, total cash price of 2 buffalo. If the SP is greater than CP, then we can say then he gain profit in he get profit in whole transaction. If CP is greater than SP, then in he milkman is get loss in whole transactions. Okay, so first fellow, one fellow, he sold at 5% profit. Okay, so let
Let cost price of first book value Vx.
Okay, cost price of first book value Vx rupees.
Okay,
now so he gained 5% profit in first book value. Okay, so profit percentage is given 5%. So this is your CP. SP is, what is SP is equal to what? SP is equal to selling price of first book value is equal to CP of first book value plus profit. Okay, so here SP is given of first book value because the milkman sold each book value at 20,000 rupees. Okay, so here you can write 20,000. Clear? And then we let the cost price of first book value is X. Clear? Plus profit. How can you find profit? CP into profit percentage. Then you can find profit.
In a very well, profit is equal to what? Profit is equal to cost price CP into profit percentage. Okay?
In this way you find profit.
This is clear? So here, this is given.
We let the CP here
and the profit is given 5%.
Okay? Profit is given 5%.
So you can write here 5 by 100. Clear? Also, you can write it. This is equal to 20x. If you cancel this, 5 into 5, 5 upon 20. 20x plus x by 20. Clear? Or you can write it 2000, 20,000 is equal to 21x by 20. This implies that x is equal to what? X is equal to 20,000 into 20 by 20. So what is the value of x? If you multiply this, then you obtain this becomes 40. Okay. So this way you can see this becomes 4 lakh. Okay. By 21. Clear? And when you divide it, then you get the value of x is equal to 19,047.62. Okay? 19,047.62 rupees. Okay? This is the CP. CP of first value, you can write it hence. CP of first book value. First book value. Rupees 19,047.62. This is clear? Now. And now we are going to solve the cost price of second book value because the milkman showed the cost price of second book value is 10% less. Okay? So here this is the cost price of first book value. Now again we let the cost price of second book value. Cost price of second book value. What is the, how can we find the cost price of second book value? Because the selling price of second book value is given here for 20,000. Milkman sold is each book value in 20,000 rupees. So this is a 20,000 rupees is a SP of each book value. So for this, we let the CP or cost price of second book value B Y rupees.
Okay.
So SP is equal to what? CP. CP minus loss. This is equal to SP. Selling price.
Okay.
So we let here CP is Y. How we find loss? We find loss is equal to Y into 10% loss given by 100. This is equal to 20,000. 20,000 is the given CP. Clear? Now, so if you cancel this, then you have here Y minus Y by 10. This is equal to 20,000.
Okay?
This is equal to 20,000, or this becomes 9 by 10. Y is equal to 20,000. Clear? Now, what is Y is equal to? Y is equal to, this will become 20,000 into 10 by 9. Then if you simplify this, then you obtain 22,222 Y2.
Okay?
So you can say, cost price of second buffalo is rupees 22,222.2. This is clear? Now,
see, here you can see the cost price of first buffalo is 19,057.62, and cost price of second buffalo is 22,222.22. Clear? So we need to find here total cost price of two buffalo. Okay? So for this, we need total cost price of two buffalo. We sum this. The cost price of one buffalo is 19,047.62. The cost price of second buffalo is 22,222.2. Okay, so here we write total cost price of two buffaloes is equal to, this is given, we find the cost of first buffalo is 19,047.62 rupees. 90,047.60 rupees, and again we find the cost of price of the second buffalo. This is equal to 22,222.22. If you sum them, then you obtain 41,269.84. Okay, 41,269.84 rupees. This is clear. Okay, so here you can see our total CP, total cost price is 41,269.84 rupees, and total selling price is 40,000. So from here, we can see from above, you can see here CP is greater than SP. From above, you can see CP is greater than SP. So what happened in the whole transaction? So therefore, here it is loss. Okay, so you can see in whole transactions it is loss. Okay, so therefore here it is loss. Therefore here in whole transaction, he faced loss. He faced loss. Okay. In whole transaction, he faced last. So what is the loss amount? We need to find loss amount. So loss amount is loss. How can you find loss amount? CP minus SP.
CP minus SP.
CP represent cost price of the two buffaloes and SP represent selling price of the two buffaloes. So here we find total CP is 41,269.84 rupees. Okay.
So 41,269.84 rupees minus 40,000 rupees. Okay. The SP of two buffaloes is 40,000 rupees. So in this way, you can see we have 269.84 rupees.
Okay. So last amount is last amount is 1,269.84 rupees. So then I hope all of you understood this question. Thank you for watching. Jai Hind.